Be my woman, girl. Party at my place. Yeah. Be my woman, girl.
Be your man.
So this pre-story is actually what makes this film happen, so you have to listen carefully now. It was in February this year when I was showing YouTuber Eric Conover around in Iceland. We go to the secret hot spring and there's a group of French people there. We're there for like 10 minutes and just when we're about to leave, one of the girls asked me if I can take a photo of them. Which I did and then found her on Facebook to send it over. Two or so days later, the other girl of the group, and we're gonna call her Hot Spring Girl from now on, she pops up, telling me thanks for the picture, some things that I already knew, and then if I ever want to make a film about the French Alps, I should let her know. Now fast forward 2 months, and here comes the twist. Me and a friend spontaneously decide to go for a GEC concert in Paris. So after I book the tickets, I post these two pictures on my Instagram story. And who swipes up like a thunder from a clear sky? Well, the Hot Spring Girl, telling me that the Eiffel Tower is not the shit in France, and I should probably use the opportunity and visit the French Alps and make a film about it. And I'm like, you know what, Hot Spring Girl? I think the French Alps are pretty far from Paris. And I also think that I don't know you at all. But at the same time, I think it's an absolute killer of an idea.
Une fleur entre les lèvres, un sourire au coin des yeux, un regard rempli de rêves et de l'or dans les cheveux. Il éteint sa cigarette et me dit venez danser, comme c'est aujourd'hui ma fête, j'ai envie de vous aimer.
So we booked this pretty fancy hotel in Paris with an Eiffel view for the shots. But the view we got was not like on the pictures. I convinced the guy in the lobby to give us the suite for 15 minutes to get this one money shot. Thankfully he said yes and I promised to give the hotel some credit. The concerts were dope, I really enjoyed myself, but it was time to do what I like even more. Road tripping in a foreign country, meeting new people and make a film about it. So the next morning we wake up super early, I'm excited for the road trip ahead. We head out to a car rental, only to find out that both of us forgot our driver's license at home. So at this point in the film, we were pretty much fucked. The good thing about being pretty much fucked, however, is that there is usually a solution for it. After some research, I find out that there is a train that goes from Paris to Grenoble. We decide to take that train, meet up with the Hot Spring Girl, and take it from there.
Sem er að fara að gerast í dag mjög cool atburður raun og veru en mér finnst það töff. Það er svona ultimate um humanity en það sem líður svona stimm á mínum öðru.
So, here's the hot spring girl. It turns out that she's actually just a pretty cool chick. She shows us around in Grenoble. We meet some of her friends. There's a really good vibe going on and things were just really falling into place. But we still had a tiny little problem that needed to be fixed. So the next morning I decide to talk to the girl at the hotel lobby and tell her about my car situation. I find out that there's actually a website called drivey.com where you can rent a car without showing a physical driver's license. What do you know?
Alright, let's fucking go.
I had heard about this really cool secret spot and our first mission in Cassis was to go and find it.
Fólk að mæta okkur sem því við erum á réttri leið. Blessaður, gamli. Nei, nei.
Got French chocolate cookies and coffee that her mom made for me yesterday. It's kinda cold, but this is fucking dope.
But on with the exploration. We've arrived in a new city. A city of 1 million people located in the French Riviera. A city where you can see a guy play 3 guitars at the same time and go to the cemetery to get B-rolls because it's that beautiful. It's quiet, elegant, and rich with history. Welcome to Nice. Living in a god of defeated, a leader driven by more than money and women. I'm giving what I was and they love it, nothing above it. I'm ready to cover them, rub it in at the end of the world. Looking for love again, young visionary. They vision very on the contrary. I'm buried alive, just trying to fill the vibe. Why they trying to fill the void? Young up and coming, I was unemployed. Now my name is something that they just cannot avoid. We say goodbye to Nice and set sail for La Motte Taverne, or however you pronounce it. The home of the hot spring girl. However, midway through our drive, I decide that we need to take a little detour.
All right.
The detour was made to see this really cool and photogenic bridge in a place called Avignon. I don't think that everyone in the car was really pleased with that decision, but for me, driving for 3 extra hours for maybe 10 or 15 extra seconds in this film, it was a no-brainer.
Yeah, what's out for the poop? What's up, man? How's it going?
Yeah, I know.
So there I was, in the middle of the Alps, making a film about it. Cause you know what? If you say you're gonna do something, just fucking do it.
Do you wanna drive your motorcycle here?
Can I?
Yeah, sure.
Sorry guys, adios.
You know this moment when you find yourself sitting on a steep ass rock like a mountain goat, surrounded by the most beautiful scenery you have ever witnessed, somewhere in the wilderness of a foreign country? And you think to yourself, how the fuck did I get here? And then it hits you. That photo you took 4 months ago, that really small act of kindness led to this whole thing. Because for every action, there's a reaction. And a hot spring girl reaction is quite a fucking thing.
Jesus, þessar kindur kunna sér ekkert hóf. God damn it, I'm trying to get some B-rolls over here, you're trying to hump it, sir. Well, what do you know? Wait, what's going on?